Welcome to all students in subject design of transmission system. We discuss about external gears. Gear drive is a positive drive and it is provided when the distance between the driver and follower is very small. Gears are defined as tooth wheels which can transmit power and motion from one shaft to the another shaft by means of successive engagement of teeth. It is important to note that both the gears which are engaged always rotate in opposite direction. The gear drive consists of two wheels. The small wheel is called as pinion and larger wheel is called as gear. Okay. When two external gears are meshed, they are rotated in opposite direction. The advantages of this gear drive is, gear drive is a positive drive and it transmits exact velocity ratio. It can transmit large power with low velocity. It has high efficiency, it is compact in size, it is more reliable than other drives. It can be used to transmit power between two shafts which are parallel, intersecting or non-parallel and non-intersecting. It can be used for changing the speed ratio over a wide range. Okay. This is the internal gear tooth. In internal gear tooth, there are most gears are external teeth on the outside. Internal gears are used with pinion gears. Then external gear rotates in the same direction of internal gear. External gear rotates opposite with another external gear. This is the diagram here. Mention pinion gear axis, ring gear axis and internal ringing gear. This is the idler gears. Floating or idler gear, driver gear. It is located between drive and driven gear. Used in reverse gear trains. Transfers motion without changing rotational direction. Desirable properties and selection of material gear. It is very important topic. Desirable properties and selection of material gear. When load carrying capacity of the gear tooth depends upon the ultimate tensile strength, of material, there is wear rating. The resistance of wear depends upon alloying element, grain size, percentage of carbon sufficient surface endurance strength to avoid failure due to destructive pitting. For high speed transmission, the sliding velocity are very high. Material should have low coefficient of friction due to scoring. The amount of heat distortion or wrapping load gets concentrated at one corner of tooth alloy steel and superior to plain carbon. Cast iron, FG 200-260 steel, bronze and phenolic resins like 45C8, 40Ni3CR, 65MO55. Okay, now we discuss about very important topic like basic mode of gear tooth failure and type of gear tooth failure. Breakage of tooth due to the static and dynamic loads and surface destruction like abrasive wear, corrosive wear, initial pitting, destructive pitting and scoring. The gear tooth failure there are two types, like bending failure or breakage of tooth or wear failure. In wear failure, there are four types like pitting, scoring, abrasive wear and corrosive wear. The pitting also two types, initial pitting and destructive pitting. In bending failure, there are breakage of tooth. Everyday tooth acts like a cantilever beam which is subjected to a respective bending stress. Due to this stress, the gear tooth may break. The continuous repetition of bending stress of varying magnitude leads to fatigue, which may result in crack and hence the gear tooth breaks away. If the total respective load, that is in bracket, sum of static load and dynamic load on the gear tooth is greater than the beam strength of gear tooth, then the gear tooth will fail in the bending. This failure can be avoided by adjusting the parameters such as module and face width of the gear design, so that the beam strength of the gear tooth is more than the total repetitive load. In wear failure, wear or surface destruction is a phenomenon which removes the complete layer of the surface, or it makes creates or scratches on the surface. Wear failure is classified on the basis of their periphery causes. The peripherical types of gear tooth wear as follows. First, pitting, like initial pitting, destructive pitting. Second, scoring. Third, abrasive wear. Fourth, corrosive wear. In pitting is a surface fatigue failure due to repetitive contact stresses. The pitting can be divided into two groups, that is initial pitting, destructive pitting. Okay, in initial pitting, the initial or corrective pitting is localized phenomenon which is characterized by small pits at a high spots. In destructive pitting, it is a second phase of pitting. It is a surface fatigue failure due to repetitive contact stresses. In scoring or galling or scuffing is a lubrication failure. Insufficient lubrication along with excessive surface pressure and high surface speed results in the breakdown of oil film. Due to this, there is rapid alternate welding and tearing at a high spots, which is called as stick slip phenomena. In this case, rate of wear is faster. In abrasive wear, it is damage or surface injury caused by the particles trapped between the mating teeth surfaces. Okay, after this we discuss about gear ratios. Can multiply torque and speed. Can reduce torque and speed. Same size and number of teeth is equal to no change in output. Equal size gear create equal output. Small drive gear to large drive one gear equal to drive one gear speed decreases. Larger driver gear to small drive one gear is equal to drive one gear speed increases. So, gear ratio is calculation as gear ratio can be found by dividing number of teeth on drive one gear by the number of teeth on the drive one gear. Example, 75 drive one teeth, 45 drive one teeth equal to 1.66 gear ratio. Now we discuss about gear reduction. In gear reduction, speed decreases, torque increases. When speed is halved, torque is doubles. Most manual transmissions are speed reducing and torque increasing. Gear overdrive. In gear overdrive, speed increases, torque decreases. When speed is double, torque is halved. Used for fuel mileages. Factory overdrives versus aftermarket overdrives. Okay, now we discuss the basic things about gear drives. So, thanks all of you.